morning.
My name's Ashley Mason and I live in Ludlow. I've lived there all my life. I've worked in the shop since I was about 11, work every Saturday and work over my holidays. I just enjoy working, being part of the shop. I've never lived anywhere else apart from going away on holidays and things like that. I don't think I've ever really wanted to live anywhere else. It's quite a quiet market town, you know, normal days in the week. Shops open 9 or round about 9-ish, you know. The town itself doesn't really start livening up till about 10:30. It's a very busy day on Monday because of the market day. You get lots of farmers and farmers' wives particularly. It's usually the day of the week when they come and do their shopping. And they go off around all the shops while their husband's down at the farm selling his cattle or whatever, and then the farmers usually come up in the afternoon.
My name is Chris Meddings. I live on a farm 20 miles or so northwest of Ludlow. I actually work for my father, doing generally everything, ranging from machinery right down to mucking out sheds and etc., doing the manual work. We farm about 700 acres, of which about 500 is down to corn and about 200 is down to grass. We aren't in a vastly populated area, in the sense that our nearest neighbour is about a mile away. Otherwise, nearest town, about 2.5, or nearest place to actually buy any clothing of any quantity is 20, 30 miles away, depending on whether it's Shrewsbury or Ludlow. We come into Ludlow for such things as food. There's a cash and carry where we buy everything in bulk. We also deal with the market, bring cattle, sell, occasionally buy, but there isn't a big store market in Ludlow. It's mostly the fat side of things. The typical kind of day that we have at the market, whether it be Ludlow or any other, is we kind of look around the stock, see what they've got, if we're selling, see if there's anything similar, or see what the butchers are actually wanting, which buyers are there. Because you got your buyers, some of them want your small cattle, some want big cattle, some like them fatter than others. We also have a big social kind of outing in this area. Your market is where you meet everybody, discuss what's going on, sort out prices for other things like hay, straw, corn, see what other people are asking or offering.
Ladies and gentlemen, now just approaching the town of Ludlow in the county of Shropshire. Population just on around 7,000. As you know, with Shropshire, it's associated with the great poet A.E. Housman. Now, as we approach the main street of Ludlow, you can just pick out the lovely Church of St. Lawrence, which is coming up in front of us on the right. Now, this church dates back to around the 15th century. And as we approach the town, you can see the market place that's here on the left. So they still hold their open day market. It's on the left. You can see many old buildings within the town. And the lovely black and white Tudor, dating right back to around the 16th century period. Now just at the top of the hill, as we arrive, you can see the very beautiful Feathers Hotel, a noted hotel within Ludlow.
The height of the tourist season starts around about June, early June. You see an awful lot of foreigners, Americans, Europeans, and people who we call foreigners from Birmingham with their foreign accents.
Good afternoon, Mr. Sturbridge.
Thank you very much. Yes. Room call. 26. Okay. Can I walk towards the castle?
It's about 4 minutes walk from here, no further.
Ludlow's not designed for the large amount of traffic congestion that we get during the tourist season itself. The streets are very narrow. There's lots of old buildings that have had corners knocked off them and had to be redone. And there's lots of buildings that are of historical interest. Practically every shop that's closed, whatever the shop has been when it's reopened, it's been an antique shop. And if you look in the centre of Ludlow, then there's at least 10 to 15 antique shops in the centre itself, which is quite an astounding amount.
More or less, for any social life, we have to create it ourselves. Make up our own committees to produce dances, put them on discos, and everything of that nature. Whereas if you live in a town, most of that tends to be laid on for you. To actually go anywhere, you basically have to travel anything from 20 to 50, 60 mile a night. We tend to go around a carload or so at a time to make it worthwhile and save on petrol, basically. It costs such a lot. And the other thing about with going around three or four of us together, it means three of us can quite happily drink the evening and not worry about having to drive home with the fourth one doing the slave work, having to drive us back. So if you want to go to a dance, meet people, anything of that nature, you have to travel. That is one of the reasons why we come to Ludlow. Besides, it offers some good pubs, and also there's some social evenings, dances as well held, and young farmers. Thank you.
it's a great asset to be mobile anywhere in the country, really, because if you want to go to a dance, you've got to travel at quite a distance to go to it. And quite often, a lot of the younger people, that my friends, for instance, live in villages around the outside of Ludlow anyway, like Richard's Castle, which is about 4 miles away, or they have to either come in or you go and pick them up and things like that. So obviously, being able to drive is a great asset. Other than that, you have to harass your parents to run into dances and things like that. Youngsters say they get very bored of living in Ludlow because they say that there's not enough facilities and not enough to do, etc., which perhaps is true to a certain extent. Within Ludlow itself, the only things to do are go out to pubs and the blues evenings that they hold in Ball on Sunday nights once a month. Other than that, the only social life is the pubs. Ludlow has nothing really to offer me as yet, and apart from going into my father's business, there's no other job prospects that would hold me here. I'd rather move away and find out for myself what I want to do in the future. Ludlow itself is very insular. It's a very protected society. It's quite a middle-class society within the town, and I think the outside world is going to be quite different to what I've grown to get used to in Ludlow, which is a shame to leave, but then I think it's a necessity in order for me to expand as a person.